Let's talk about Hurricane Florence, now a dangerous Category 4 storm as it moves toward the East Coast. It is expected to make landfall either later Thursday night or early the wee hours of Friday morning. Mandatory evacuations are underway for parts of the Carolinas. CNN meteorologist Allison Chinchar is tracking Florence for us. And Allison, tell me more.
Right. So the concern now is how much more intensification does this storm go through before it finally makes landfall? Right now, it's a very powerful Category 4 storm. Winds 130 miles per hour, gusting to 140 miles per hour. The track still eventually likes to make landfall somewhere between Virginia and South Carolina. Now, this does not mean these are the only areas that will be impacted. This just basically tells you where the center of circulation is expected to be and the strongest winds. But rain is actually going to be probably the biggest concern with this particular storm. We expect widespread amounts of rain well over 10 inches, but there will be some locations that could pick up in excess of 20, if not even 30 inches of rain. Now, the question is where those areas are going to be. Who's going to get the most rain? That ultimately will be determined on where that landfall location is there. The point is that all of the models are agreeing that there is going to be a tremendous amount of rain dumped, but that's not the only concern. And I want people to realize that cone that shows Virginia to South Carolina, that's only for the center of circulation. Everywhere from Florida all the way up to Massachusetts is likely to have some type of impact, whether that's rip currents, strong gusty winds, beach erosion, or even the hazardous surf. Those are all likely to have where you see this purple color on this map. So say if you live in New Jersey or Florida, you still need to understand that you're likely to have tropical storm force winds as this storm makes landfall. But this is not the only storm that we're keeping an eye on. Believe it or not, we actually have three hurricanes that we've been keeping an eye on over portions of the Atlantic. We also have Helene, and we also have Isaac that we'll be keeping a close eye on, Brooke, in the coming days.
Allison, I know you will. Thank you so much. And, you know, people are certainly taking heed to these warnings to be prepared. Stores quickly trying to restock supplies like water, groceries, plywood, even gasoline. Lowe's in North Carolina actually sold out of generators, they're telling us, in about 20 hours. North Carolina has requested federal disaster declarations. In South Carolina, just deployed 800 members of the National Guard ahead of what is expected to be catastrophic flooding. CNN's Kaylee Hartung is in Wilmington, North Carolina, where I know people have ridden out many a storm, but Category 4 certainly packs a punch.
Yeah, that's right, Brooke. And so many stores here are having trouble keeping up their stock with the demand for those hurricane necessities. This Lowe's behind me trying to keep their generators in stock as best they can, but they have been the most in-demand item. And many people here, first-time generator buyers, because any of the longtime residents you talk to here say you have to go back about 20 years for people to remember the kind of preparation that's necessary for this storm that's coming their way. You mentioned people who've been known to ride out storms here, Brooke. I want to bring in Terry Jackson. He's a longtime resident here in Wilmington. And Terry, you say you and your wife have made the decision to ride out this storm. Why is that?
Yes, I've been giving a lot of thought for the last couple of days. Like yesterday, we were coming back from Tennessee from a mountain trip, and we've been keeping update with some friends, and they told us to, you know, how bad it was getting. So we decided to stop in Raleigh, North Carolina, outside of Fuquay Arena. And believe it or not, those grocery stores were jam-packed, so that made me think a little bit. So we got back into Wilmington, and, you know, we decided just to, we're going to ride it out. And I've lived here all my life, and I've never, you know, gone through a hurricane. And today, like you said, today was my first day buying a generator this morning at Lowe's at 8:30 this morning.
What else was on that shopping list now that you've made the determination you're going to stay? How are you preparing?
Well, my wife, she went to Bed Bath & Beyond, and she bought a fan, you know, a box fan. We got five cases of water. We've got chips, all the canned necessities, batteries, flashlights. We got to make sure our little pets got plenty of food and prescriptions, you know, all that good stuff. So we've basically got everything we need, four bags of ice, and we're just going to wait it out right now just for a few minutes, I mean for a couple days, and see how it goes.
Well, good luck to you and your wife, Terry.
Thank you.
Brooke, the governor of North Carolina says the best safety plan is preparation and common sense. For many people here, though, they're glad they've got time on their side to make those preparations.
Kaylee, we'll be talking to you, I'm sure, over the course of the next couple of days, and people like Terry who will make that decision to ride out this hurricane. Thank you so much.